dear children, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now in the last video, we discussed about the India 6 physical division. Am I right? So today we are going to start India political division. So now here we discuss about India political division. Now the Constitution of India is the governing authority of 29 states and 7 union territories. Now what is the constitution? Means every country has set the rules to which government rule the country. Now here the Constitution of India is the governing authority, means it's a ruling authority of 29 states and 7 union territories. As you know, in India many states are there. There are 29 states and 7 union territories. Now you should know what is the government. You know what is government? The government is the governing body that look after the welfare and safety of the people. It frames the law for the country to run very smoothly. It frames the law to run the country very smoothly. It also provides electricity, water, telephone and communication. It is the government which decides where to build road, school, hospital, stadium, airport, etc. Now, as you all know, India is a big country, so it is very difficult for one government to look after the big country. So hence it was decided to divide it into smaller unit, and that is called a states. So how many states are there? How many units it is divided? How many states are there? There are 29 states. Now for governing such a big country, the government has formed two levels. Now my dear children, first we'll take example of your school. Your school is also very big, right? And your school is also divided into primary, pre-primary, primary and secondary. And every section had coordinator, and every class have a class teacher. So like this way it is divided, so it is very easy to look after your school. One principal cannot look after the whole school. She cannot go in every class and she cannot teach. So it is divided among the teacher and the head and coordinator. Now here same we will talk about the India. India is also very big country, so it is not possible for one government to look after the country. Now so because of that, it is divided into two level. The government has been divided into two level. That is the first, that is a central level, and next, that is a state level. Now we'll talk about the central level. The central government, it consists of Prime Minister, President and Council of Minister. You know the who is the Prime Minister of our country? Narendra Modi. He is the Prime Minister of our country. So now here the central government is the head of our country. And central government also look after the state government whenever the help is needed. Now, I hope you have understood about the central level. Central level, it consists of the Prime Minister, President and Council of Minister. Now, we'll discuss the state level. So, every state has its own government. And every state has its own government, which consists of Governor, Chief Minister and other minister. This all they work for their state. Okay, now this all minister they look after the state. So how they help the state government? They look the state government look after the education, health and the welfare of the people, and also they maintain the laws. In this way they help the government. Now my dear children, as you know, every state has its own capital. As Rajasthan is the largest state of India, and Goa is the smallest state. Density of population. And Uttar Pradesh, here you see the highest population. Right? Now, my dear children, after that we will discuss about the union territories. Now, union territories are under the control of central government. It is not included in the state government. The union territories are under the control of the state government. And there are how many union territories are there? We talk there are 7 union territories. Now, there are 7 union territories in India, including the national capital territory of Delhi. Hope you have understood about the government, the central government, the state government, and we talk about the union territory. Now, here one concept about the 7 sister. Now, what is the 7 sister? Now, the 7th state of the northeast is called the 7th sister. So, which are these 7 sister? Which states come? That is Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, and Tripura. These all 7 states is known as 7th sister. Now, my dear children, what you have to do is I talk about that India, that every state has its own capital. Now, what you have to do? You have to open your textbook and you have to read the capital which is given in your textbook. You have to learn the capital, and one homework for you, you have to make one chart. In that, you have to write the state and its capital. Got it? You have to read also. You should know that state and its capital. You have to make the chart, and this you can do till next Monday. Hope you have understood the lesson about the India physical and political division. Thank you.